हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द क्लास। बेटा, इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी रेड अबाउट द फॉल ऑफ जेकोबिन गवर्नमेंट एंड हाउ द डायरेक्टली रूल फ्रांस। आफ्टर दैट वी रेड अबाउट द रेवोल्यूशन बाय द वुमेन एंड व्हाट राइट दे गॉट आफ्टर द रेवोल्यूशन, एंड ऑल्सो वी रेड अबाउट द स्लेव ट्रेड इन फ्रांस एंड हाउ द स्लेवरी वॉज एबोलिश्ड इन फ्रांस। सो दीज टॉपिक्स वी डिस्कस्ड इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर, and today we will read about the topic the revolution and the changes in everyday life in France, and also beta there were so many changes in the everyday life of France as the censorship was abolished. Now people are free to express their feelings. Even print media, it also got right to print even against the government. After that, we will read about the rise of Napoleon Bonaparte. When the Jacobin government fall, after that, Napoleon Bonaparte, he came into rule. And first of all, he was known as a liberator. He was known as the modernizer of Europe. But later on, he declared himself a dictator of France. So, we will read all these topics in today's lecture. Let us start the topic with the revolution and everyday life. How the revolution impacted everyday life? After that, censorship was abolished. Because you know that in old regime, books, plays, newspapers could be published only after the approval of censors of the king. Means all these books and plays, these were checked by the censor of the king. But now, newspaper and other printed material, they describe the events and changes taking place in France. It means now they were free. Then, there was declaration of the rights of man and citizen, proclaimed freedom of speech and expression to be a natural right. It means now citizen, they had the right to express their feelings and it was their natural right. After that, freedom of press was given, and even ideas of liberty and justice, they were discussed everywhere in France now. Now, what was the legacy of French Revolution? What was the outcome? What we got from the French Revolution? The ideas of liberty and democratic rights were the most important legacy. These spread from France to the rest of Europe. Even during 19th century, Tipu Sultan and Ram Mohan Rai were two examples who responded to the ideas coming from revolutionary France. Means all these rights of right to equality and liberty, it spreads all over the world. Now the next topic is rise of Napoleon Bonaparte. In 1804, Napoleon Bonaparte crowned himself as the Emperor of France. He set out to conquer, to win neighboring European countries. He saw his role as a modernizer. Firstly, he introduced laws. These laws were protection of private property and a uniform system of weights and measures. Initially, many saw him as a liberator who would bring freedom, but soon his armies were viewed as an invading force, and he was finally defeated at the Battle of Waterloo in 1850. So this was about the rise of Napoleon and how he was defeated at the Battle of Waterloo. So this was all about this chapter. So let's have a quick recap of the chapter. Beta, in 1774, Louis XVI became the emperor. He belonged to the Bourbon family. And when we got the throne, at that time, treasure was empty. So he decided to increase the taxes. And there to increase the tax, that decision was taken in the meeting of Estate General. So he called the meeting of Estate General, and in that, all the three estate people were invited. And there were 300 people from first estate, 300 from second estate, and 600 people from the third estate were there. But this time they demanded the equal right to vote. means every person, every member should have a should have one vote. But this was denied by Louis XVI. So the third estate people, they walked out of the estate general meeting, and later on they gathered in a in indoor tennis court, and they swore over there not to disperse till the constitution was framed, which will limit the power of monarch. And with that, when they were busy in drafting the constitution, then in the countryside, women protested against the long queues at the bakery shops, and even the peasants, they attacked on the manures, on the noble and clergy. At that time, Louis XVI, then he agreed to accept the constitution. This way, France became a constitutional monarchy. But in this constitution also, only the active citizens, they got right to vote. And do you know, these active citizens, they belong to the prosperous families, and the and even they had to pay the taxes equal to the 3 days labor of the 3 days equal to the 3 days wages of the labor. So it means at that time also people didn't get equal right, and even women and less prosperous men, they were considered as the passive citizen. Now after that, Jacobin, so many political club came into existence to just to discuss the ideas given by the various thinkers like Rouzé. So they gave ideas of that three organs of the government, the social contract between the government and the representative. So now this in this political club, Jacobin government, Jacobin club was the most famous, and its head was the Maximilian Robespierre. Now he came into rule, and he ruled so strictly that his rule is known as the Reign of Terror. And after even he imposed so many strict rule that after some time assembly sent him to assembly passed the law and sent him to guillotine. After the fall of Jacobin government, Directory came into rule. And this directory, it included two legislative assembly, and further there were five executive, but it also create political instability. And in this political instability, after that, like in today's topic we discussed, Napoleon Bonaparte, he came into the rule, and 1804 he also defeated over there. So this was the quick recap of the chapter. Hope all of you have understood the topic, and today only I will send you the question answer based on this topic that I have discussed now. Thank you and have a nice day.